This is another example on how to remove epsilon productions from a grammar. In this example, we have an A that goes to an epsilon, so this is an empty production, but the A also can derive to other strings like A or to other things with another non-terminal in it. And as I said in another video, if you want to do a derivation, for example, let's say S goes to BAB, and if you use the epsilon production, then this A just falls out and you get something, you get a string like this. But if you want, in this case, if you want to do some other things with the A, then it just doesn't fall out. So you get maybe, let's take the first one, you get B, A, B, and that is something we don't want to lose. So what we do is, for this first case where we have where the A goes to an epsilon, we just can do the same as in the last video. We just skip this step and say that S just can derive in one step to BAB. But we need to keep this production to do all the other things with the A. But now as we now we have the possibility that S can derive to BAB because we added this rule, and this would be the string derived when A goes to epsilon, so we don't need those epsilon rule anymore. I think I made it clear. If we would take this part and using the epsilon production, we would get this, and we just skip the step and derive directly to this. And if we want to do the other steps with the A, then we can still use this rule and do the other things with it. So now we just have the S goes to epsilon. As I said, this is the only rule that is allowed in an epsilon-free production, as long as the S does not appear in any right-hand side of a rule.